All right, Kyle, let's talk about the Illini. I want to talk about your career first off. Okay, you obviously didn't meet your goals winning that NCAA title.
No, nope.
Finalist twice.
Yep.
Okay, first time losing to Powell.
Yep.
And then kind of a lopsided match.
Yeah, I got that first takedown, then got my butt kicked. Just got in a snowball of back points, but yeah.
Has that ever happened to you, what Powell did? Had that ever happened to you ever before in your career, before or after that?
No, when I was younger, I mean, a couple times, I would get caught in a bad possession and, you know, something like that. I might get caught in a headlock and pinned or something stupid like that. But, no, I wrestled them a couple times before that year, and they were close matches. I think one went into overtime, and the other one was fairly close. But the other two times, I got away quickly because I know he's good on top, so I knew I needed to get the heck out. NCAA Finals. You know, no excuses. He got on top. He did his thing and kicked my butt and made me look bad. And it was embarrassing, but that's how it went. And some good motivation for the next year. But yeah, I don't know if it was third day. I didn't seem to do too good both times. I mean, I don't know if I was tired, if I worked too hard at wrestling or getting my weight down in other days. But have to hand it to him. He got on top. He did his thing and kicked my butt. So that's how it went.
And the Dubuque match was that a point?
Yes, a point or two. I'd beaten him a few times that year. And then his coaching staff and him did a great job. I think they had a different game plan. Before he'd come at me, I came at him, it'd just be a brawl of a match. I mean, he'd be scoring points, I'd score points, it'd be a fight. He's a tough competitor, and he's a goer, and it was fun. But that time, he did a good job of holding off my leg attacks and things like that, and held it scoreless till the third period, and then I tried to get out. I tried my hardest to get out. Tried to keep going, and he clung on me good and rode me, and I didn't get out. And I get a lot of crap from my coaches that I'm not good on bottom, but I don't know. I think I'm pretty good at bottom and go pretty hard, but he rode me out that time, and it was a tough match, but did a good job.
Do you think you took that? Did you take a lot from that into your coaching career then at WVU?
Oh, for sure. I like to take a lot of things in my coaching career. A lot of the stuff is I figured out what their strategies have been against me, because I like to get out there, I like to shoot, I like to move a lot. And a lot of the stuff that people have done to me, I'll take it and strategy-wise and help other people out, because I know with me, a lot of people try to stay away from me. You know, keep the score close going into the closing periods and try to ride me out or something like that. Because usually if I get, my goal is always to get a takedown, at least two takedowns that first period. If I got that, I knew I was doing well and I would increase my chances of winning the match pretty well. But yeah, as far as certain setups, things like that, I've taken a lot of my career and a lot of my past coaches, like Coach Jordan and Coach Hunter and Heffernan and Johnson and Perry at Illinois. I've taken a lot of the stuff that they've taught me and applied it and kind of, put my own style on some things, but applied to a lot of what they've taught me into coaching guys.
Okay, you talk about you like wrestling on your feet. Do you think us as a whole, and by us as a whole, I mean the state of Ohio, do we wrestle too much on our feet?
I don't know too much, but I think we do a good job wrestling on our feet. I think it's highly emphasized, for sure, and I think it's great. But definitely, I think you gotta be able to take the guy down. If you get taken down, and if you want to get back up to your feet to shoot or whatever and score some more points, you have to be able to get off bottom. That's huge. And if you want to open up some matches or punish some people or slow some guys down, you have to be good on top too. So I know I'm not. This isn't rocket science or anything like that. You have to be good at all positions. And Maybe we do need to focus a little bit more on top, or focus a little bit more on bottom. But I think a lot of coaches know that, and they're working on that. And people are working hard on their feet too. But I think all positions.
All positions.
Yeah.
But Ohio, especially, we definitely emphasize the feet more. Did you notice that going into Illinois?
Yeah, and I don't know if we emphasize the feet more or what, but a lot of the coaches I've had have just been very good teachers of setting the guy up and putting things together on your feet to get takedowns and things like that. But I've learned some really good stuff on bottom from coaches, and there's been some good coaches that have coached me on top too. But I can definitely see what you're saying though. I mean, I'm not going to lie, my favorite position is on my feet for sure, but that's just because I like to move a lot. I like to go for takedowns. But
we've had some great guys on top in the state. Heskett,
yeah, Joe
Percival.
Heskett. Percival's
we've had some real
awesome
freaks on top, but
yeah,
as a whole, we are a feet state. Now,
yeah,
let's move on to senior year, disappointing at Illinois.
Okay, sure.
Lose first round, right?
Yep, first round.
Did that make you not want to go into coaching and you didn't come back an All-American your senior year?
No, not at all. I felt really good at Big Tens that year. I felt like I peaked. I felt really good going into Nationals. Sometimes you just don't have a good tournament. I wanted to do good. My body kind of wasn't doing the things I wanted it to do. I just didn't wrestle good. Maybe during the matches I didn't have a good mindset. I don't know what it was, but no excuses. I didn't do what I planned to do. I worked my butt off all year. I didn't, slack off or go out and party too much or any of that stuff. I tried to stay determined, keep my weight down, work hard, wrestle my coaches and have them kick my butt all the time, like Perry and Hunter. Of course, I think I can take them now. Just
what do you
kidding.
Weigh, what
just
do you
kidding,
weigh
Perry,
now? What do you weigh now?
I would say it might be like 153, 154, 155,
so
something
not really
like
that. But not that big. Like some guys get 170.
Oh, yeah, not that big. But, I mean, if I had to make 25 again, I'd be pushing it probably. So, but no, I didn't slack off. It was just didn't wrestle as well as I wanted to, and it just happened. And I don't know if how to figure that out, but I'm not going to dwell on it because I'm going to look forward and I have other goals. So,
okay, talk about the direction of the Illini. They just hired Coach Heffernan.
Yeah, I'm very excited for him. I was kind of engulfed in med school, so I check flow from time to time and some other things, and I saw that they hired Coach Heffernan, and I feel terrible. I need to send him an email and thank him because great choice. He's been so loyal to the program. He's a technician master. He's always been great to us. NCAAs would do our laundry and things like that to make us comfortable in our groceries and things like that, and took care of us. And to anyone they're recruiting, he's a great guy. They have a great staff. They're not only caring about wrestling, but anything. You can go to them about academics. You can go to them about if you're having any kind of problems. They're just great guys. They'll listen. Great staff, great technicians, and it's a great school. I liked it a lot there. So.
Wow, it sounds like do you bleed blue and orange?
Yeah, a little bit, unless it's football season. I'm not going to lie. I'm a little bit of an Ohio State Buckeye fan. But any from Ohio should know that. Growing up, I'd watch all the Buckeye football games. But I don't know. It was tough because they had that Juice Williams this year in football. They were pretty fun to watch in football this year. The Illini were. So it's pretty cool. But, yeah, definitely in wrestling, I kind of bleed blue and orange a little bit. But I definitely have had a great experience at West Virginia with coaching and bleed a little bit of blue and gold as well. So.
Okay. Last thing I want to let you off the hook here. What's a better wrestling high school state, Ohio or Illinois?
Oh, sorry, Coach Heffernan. I have to go Ohio. I don't have to think about that.
Really?
Ohio is where it's at.
Are your teammates, old teammates, gonna get you on that one?
Yeah, they fought. My old teammates would fight with me about that, and I respect them. They do a great job, and they have great clubs, and they're doing great. I'm just biased. I'm not gonna lie. I'm biased. I'm from Ohio. Of course, I'm gonna say Ohio, and Pennsylvania people, they'll argue at West Virginia. They argue with me all the time. I am not going to say they're better. Ohio's better, but they're both great states. A lot of states are doing real well. A lot of kids are wrestling younger and younger and getting great coaches with great college experience and doing a great job. So everyone's doing good.
All right, Kyle. Thanks for the time today, man. And I like the technique, even though we didn't get to see your bread and butter.
Yeah, no problem. I hope I didn't mess up too bad. We'll see.
We will see.